Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net, and today we're going to be troubleshooting an issue on our Yamaha T60 outboard. It has a no start condition, and when I say a no start condition, I mean it won't do anything. So what I need to do now is get the cowling out of the way and at least hook up a temporary wiring harness so we can start picking this thing apart. So if you're ready, we'll dive into this thing. So what we're going to do is just bring in a wiring harness and then the battery connections to simulate it being on the back of a boat. Then we can start picking through it and see what's going on with this. So, like I said, nothing. Nobody home at all. So let's start picking through this. We'll start with the most obvious thing first. Let's check out its main fuse and make sure it's still intact. Now you can do this with a test light, but I prefer to actually know the voltage. So we're gonna set this to DC volts. Let's find us a ground. Now we should have 12 volts right there, and we do, because that's your battery voltage coming up, which goes to this side of the starter relay. So we've got 12.48 volts, which should be more than enough to turn this over. Now, the trigger side should be right here. And I'm looking at the brown wire. So when I turn that ignition, we should be sending voltage. Well, guess what? There's nothing there. So what other conditions can cause this not to be sending power? Well, one will be your lanyard. And this is a brand new key switch. So I would find it hard to believe that it has a problem. But if this isn't connected, you're not gonna send anything back through. So now what we wanna test is to see if there's voltage coming here, which there should be. There's our ignition on, nothing. So guys, this is looking like there is an actual problem inside this harness, because I should be able to see voltage from one point to another. And just for kicks, we're gonna do a continuity test, which it should be right at 0 ohms in between those two points. So let's switch over to ohms, and then we'll actually turn on the sound, and when these two points come together, that's what we should hear. And we're looking at the brown wire, nothing. And let's take our switch out of it completely. Brown wire should be right there, nothing. And this part of the harness is brand new. Our existing harness is up here. Now the harness I'm using, guys, I'm using just half of it. I'm using just the key switch. I'm not using or hooking up a binnacle. So if you're doing that, which I kind of doubt, keep in mind that the binnacle or sidearm mount, they're gonna have a neutral switch, and that's part of this brown wire that we're tracing down. So without that plugged in, you need to jumper that wire, the brown one that comes in and goes back out, because that's where the neutral switch is if you were using one of these. So now we want to check continuity of the engine harness itself, because I'm getting the feeling that there's a break on this brown wire, and this will verify it, because if we go in and she beeps, then we know we're good. So the wire or the plug that we're looking for is that one right there. So that should be your brown one. Let's see what we got. So we didn't get anything. So that tells me there's an open circuit. So in between here and here, that brown wire is broken, because there are no other circuits and it should have shown me some type of resistance. So this harness, I'm afraid, is gonna need to be replaced, and that's our problem. Now, where is it broken in the harness? I don't know. But we could actually pull it off and then fillet it open very carefully with a razor blade, but I wouldn't trust that if I were you. So we're actually going to remove it, install a new one, and then I bet you she's going to turn over. So let's see. All right, guys, so here's the harness that we're going to be replacing. Basically, there's a break somewhere in between the connection to the controls and this ignition wire right here. So somewhere in there, that must be broken on that old one. Step number one, disconnect your battery or turn off your battery switch, whichever one your boat may be equipped with, because I'd rather not have a fireworks show while we're doing this. Now, as far as this goes, there's no order of operations. We're just going to go plug by plug and ground by ground and get this new harness in there. Pushing these together, make sure you hear that or feel that click where that little indention is to make sure they're connected fully. Everything's color-coded, so this shouldn't be that tough. That's the majority of it right there, guys. Let's see what else we got. As you're doing this, make sure none of your wires are corroded. Make note of your colors difference here. The white's up top, and that one with the kind of yellow stripe is down below. Plus it'll be the shorter wire for your coils. Now if you're concerned about getting your routing correct, what I did before I even started is I took pictures to show where each wire was laid in. So if I'm unsure about how something was routed, it'll guide me back to the right direction. All right, there it is. This isn't that complicated, guys. You just want to make sure you route all the wires back the way they came. It can be easy to miss one of these grounds. Now these two were plugged off on the old harness, so I went and got the plugs off of it so we can cap them off. All right, last but not least, let's get our harness hooked up. Our harness adapter, I should say. Get our battery hooked up. All right, guys, moment of truth. Oh, yeah. Well, listen, if you need these or any other parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.